some encouraging signs for Chris Creighton's Eagles, despite the loss here at Northern Illinois. Chad, you look at what Reggie Bell was able to do, another 100-yard performance for him, and Ryan Brumfield combined 245 yards on the ground and two touchdowns, but it just wasn't enough.
No, the two running attacks were very encouraging. Reggie Bell, and you wanted to get at least one of the backs or a combination of them to really excel today. You get the rushing yards, but the passes that were dropped, the penalties that were given, really negated a strong offensive attack. And there were some signs defensively as well, but just not enough if you're going to beat a team like Northern Illinois to get the win today.
Chris Creighton, the head coach, very frustrated at the loss at Massachusetts last week. Didn't feel like his team played with enough fire. There's no question they came out with a focus and a purpose despite the loss today.
Energy and emotion. He said, we got to bring it today if we have a chance to win. And they did. They brought that. And that's encouraging, and they should bring that. But they're going to have to bring it in the next week against Central Michigan, who comes into town.
I was just going to say, I mean, you look at incentive, there's plenty there for Eastern Michigan. Central Michigan is here next week, and then it's off to Kalamazoo, back-to-back games against your two biggest rivals.
Michigan MAC Trophy, and this is important to Eastern Michigan. So they know that Central Michigan is a dangerous team, a team that beat Northern Illinois just 2 weeks ago. Mm-hmm. So they're going to have to do some things. They do get them at home in the first homestand of the year, and the only homestand of the year. So it'll be encouraging, and I think there's enough today, so enough electricity, enough plays made. It's going to bring these fans back and gives them a bit of some hopeful things to come.
No question about it. And here's what else is very hopeful for Eastern Michigan's offense. Today, 82 plays, second most they've had all season long. Time of possession, the second most as well. If they can carry that over against the Chippewas next week, we might be talking about Eastern's second Mid-American Conference win of the season. For all the latest on Eastern Michigan football and Eastern Michigan athletics, go to emueagles.com.